Today, we shall reflect on the life of St Philip Neri. St Philip Neri was born in Florence to a lawyer named Francisco and his wife Lucrezia on the 21st of July 1515. Giving up his commercial activities at the age of 26, he went to Rome to seek his own sanctification and that of his own fellow men. His accomplishment of this twin objective was impressive. He led a disciplined life of prayer and penance and studied philosophy and theology. He frequently visited the seven churches, a 12-mile pilgrimage which he would perform on foot after sundown, often spending entire nights in the catacomb of Saint Sebastian. His inexhaustible, affectionate interest in his fellow men drove him to pay charitable visits to the sick in the hospital, and with his gentle, winning personality and cheerful spirit, to draw the worldly and irreligious into conversion on the street, in the stores or in workrooms. In 1548, he founded a confraternity to care for poor pilgrims, and he then started the monthly adoration of the Blessed Sacrament. As a result of this remarkable lay apostolate, his confessor, Father Persiano Rosa, urged that Philip could serve the church even better as a priest. Ordained priest on the 23rd of May 1551, he was appointed to the Church of St. Girolamo della Carita, where he went on to become an outstanding confessor and counselor. Philip Neri proved to be a sign of contradiction, combining as he did popularity with deep piety against the background of a corrupt Rome and a disinterested clergy. He would celebrate Mass with loving, ecstatic devotion and devote his afternoon to engaging young men and boys in talks, games or visits to the seven churches. He tried above all to cultivate cheerfulness, deep fervor, humility, mortification of the will rather than of the body, and frequent confession. This more as means for spiritual instruction than because of mortal sins. His confessional was thus frequented by cardinals, clerics and beggars alike, and among those who consulted him were the saints of great renown like Ignatius of Loyola and Charles Borromeo. Philip could bring home to the minds of people spiritual truths in the most unusual but efficacious ways. From 1564, several of his followers became priests and settled down with him at the church of San Giovanni de Florentini, praying and eating in common, celebrating the Eucharist and preaching regularly. This sowed the seed of what was to be known as the Oratory, whose distinctive feature was the regular afternoon session of informal talks concerning spiritual life, scripture, church history and lives of the saints, interspersed with prayers and hymns in the vernacular, often with musical settings by greats like Palestrina. Formal approval for this society, whose members took no vows, came from Pope Gregory XIII in 1575. The unquestioned success of this second apostle of Rome never had any effect on his humility, a profound virtue that enabled him to endure tremendous persecution under the reigns of Popes Paul IV and Pius V. One of the most outstanding mystics during the Counter-Reformation, Philip passed away on the feast of Corpus Christi, that is, the 26th of May 1595. And was canonized by Pope Gregory XV on 12th of May 1622.